brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me and for their love. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With rebondment and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death. For according to his words, God will take care of him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
Where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder in every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but you do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord upholds my life. In the missalette, before the reading, he gives that little reflection. And in the missalette, it asks the question, how many of us have been told that we should always put ourselves first? That we should look out for number one, me. But is that the way we as Christians are called to live? We are called to follow the example of Jesus Christ. Now, in today's gospel, it begins by saying Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it.
because he wanted that time to be intimate with him and his disciples. And he was teaching them what must come about, that the Son of Man is to be handed over to men and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise. Of course, his disciples did not understand what this meant. And we kind of hear that connection with today's first reading. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doing, reproaches us for transgressions of the law," something which ultimately our Lord invited and challenged others to live the gospel, especially the leaders. And it goes on to the very end, "Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of it." Which takes us back to the responsorial psalm, "The Lord upholds my life." The Lord, the Father, lifted his Son up on the cross. Indeed, when the disciples were discussing among themselves who was the greatest, Jesus tells them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be last of all and servant of all." But then Jesus does something. At the conclusion of the gospel, he says, taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me." And why did Jesus embrace the child? Because a child represents innocence. A child represents purity. A child's very natural instinct often is to help others. Children desire to be helpful. And so Jesus basically says a child puts the needs of others before themselves. Now, of course, for us, it doesn't mean we don't take care of ourselves. That's not what that means. We should take care of ourselves. But our natural inclination should be caring for others, much like the Lord cared for us and laid down his life for us. Humility. It takes us to the second reading of the letter to St. James. "Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure." Wisdom of above, the Lord's wisdom. Now, sometimes there's nothing more frustrating for me, and of course I add this myself, so don't take offense, but egos and personalities. Sometimes dealing my own ego and own personality. Because we should really always be thinking with the mind of God, which is pure, innocent, beautiful. But so often we make the mistake that we don't live for the kingdom, but rather we live for ourselves. We live for the world, which leads us down to the wrong path. And you know, if we think about what has occurred in the last several years, what we have experienced in many ways is demonic at its core. Because we hear about worldliness, heart's desire should be for the kingdom. And unfortunately, in so many ways, we have been scandalized by the failures and the sins of others. You know, why does the devil so often, you know, in recent years, the most painful thing that we have experienced, brothers and sisters, you've experienced, I've experienced as a priest, is when young people are harmed. Why? Why does the devil go after the young? Because the devil knows when we hurt the image of a child, we hurt the image of God. And yet, we need to acknowledge that. We need to acknowledge our failures and apologize for our failures, for the hurt that we caused. So many young people and their families that have been scarred. We have failed. And yes, even in recent times again, we have failed. Over and over again, we failed. And I say this, even during the time of the pandemic, to minister to others in need. We need to pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that we become more holy and more pure. And this is challenging, because we so often want to keep up an image. And so as I listen to the gospel, we must become humble. We must work together to put aside egos and personalities. We need to trust the Lord with all our heart, soul, and strength. And so today, at the conclusion of Mass, last week we rang the bells in honor of 9/11, but I intentionally wore these vestments because I'm going to do something that I did in 2018 when the scandals bubbled up to the surface. I'm going to take off my vestments with the exception of the hour. The vestments which represent the authority of the priesthood, the chasuble, the stole, the manacle, the cincture. And I will go out in the baptismal garment. And as I do that, and as we are singing, saying the prayer of St. Michael and singing the closing hymn, I want you to pray for purity, holiness in the church, that her leaders will become more holy. That we, you, my dear brothers and sisters, become more holy with our eyes focused on Christ. Because wisdom from above is pure. And we need to rely on that wisdom from above that is pure. We cannot allow wars and conflicts to bubble to the surface. We need to turn to the Lord. We need to embrace the Lord with all our heart, soul, and strength. And as we embrace humility, the Lord embraces us. And as the Lord embraces us, we receive Him and the One who sent Him into the world. resurrection. Through him, the suffering servant, let us bring our petitions to the Father of all mercies.
For our Holy Father, who is the servant of servants of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and harmony between those nations set against one another, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to jealousy and destructive competition among members of our families, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians working for the welfare and protection of children in our community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our catechists and educators who help our children learn, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those visiting our parish this weekend and for their intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of the holy sacrifice of the Mass being offered for the living and deceased members of Andrew and Bertha Smith family, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of our Savior, these prayers we bring before you express our faith in your Son, who humbled himself to die on the cross for us and rose again to be our glorious Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs to these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For you so love the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by thy sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. and in the manner of our life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Religious education classes start tomorrow from 9:15 to 10:30. Also tomorrow, it is the third Sunday of the month, and it is in that season again to take out turkey dinner. And so I encourage you to come out, purchase the turkey dinner. You know, you get a lot of food for a reasonable price, $10. Also, if you have the opportunity, you know somebody who is homebound, you know, take a meal or two out to them. You know, one meal gets you almost two. And last but not least, it will save your prep time and your cleanup time so you can spend more time with your family. So, most important. So, think, consider it, and it's good. Trust me. Also, you know, as they take off the vestments and place them on the altar, they place the chasuble represents charity. May we with love lay down our lives on the altar of the Lord. Also, the manacle represents the weight of the priesthood, the weight of the cross. As I place that on the altar, may we pray that we may always bring our concerns and our needs before the Lord. As I place the stole, which represents the authority of Christ, that in everything we may do all things for Christ and for his glory. And as I remove the cincture, which represents chastity and purity, may we pray that we may become more pure. And everything we pray, we strive to go back to the purity of our baptismal garment. And so we do so in faith, and we trust the Lord with all our heart, soul, and strength. And we trust the Lord as we go forth in peace. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
and the Saint Gabriel,
we are our protection
and spirit of the
Spirit.
May God renew you from the dead,
and in your
life of his tribulations,
by the mind of God,
cast in
all faith,
in
all spirits,
to
run out
for our seeking
for the
souls.
Amen.
Closing in number 935, Glory and Praise to our God. Everyone, thank you for joining us from at home. Please know that you are in our prayers, and I ask God's blessing to be with you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. I hope you have a good weekend, a good week. We'll join you on Monday morning at 7:30 for our weekly morning gatherings. God bless you. Have a good weekend.